The next point I'd like to raise is that the government is paid by the people to enact the law. We've just discussed that the law is that you must not injure your neighbour, and if you do it knowingly or intentionally, it's criminal. The government have knowingly passed Acts of Parliament to allow unnecessary and unreasonable environmental damage and destruction, which constitutes aggravated criminal damage. They've acted to allow it, and they've omitted to control it. The government is therefore reckless and criminal by act and omission in its duty of care for the environment, to the extent that it's committed aggravated criminal damage. It's a very serious crime. It carries a maximum life imprisonment. It is not only unlawful for a contract to unduly influence or coerce a contract to unduly influence or coerce a person to commit a crime, as the mortgage contract is doing, it is also unlawful to pay someone to commit crime. Now, if the government is guilty of aggravated criminal damage to the environment, which it seems they are, and if no person is above the law, which they're not, then it is unlawful to pay tax until the government stops being criminal. This applies to every country in the world. I don't know the first thing about Chinese law, but I know they live there in groups, and therefore they adhere to that principle that members of a group do not, as a general rule, injure each other, which is the same as the duty of care, which says you must take care not to injure your neighbour. It's unlawful to pay tax until the government stops being criminal. Now, if the threat of environmental damage is as serious as the threat of a war, then it's unlawful to pay tax until the same amount of resources used for the environment as would be used to fight a war. It's a very different quality of threat, so it's a very different quality of resource. What I advocate is a global state of emergency for permaculture. And if you look up permaculture, P-E-R-M-A, culture, permaculture.org, you'll see the website there. It'll give you a good idea of what permaculture is all about. I have a definition of permaculture, which is to use all of our splendid and amazing technology for the benefit of humanity as it was intended by its inventors and according to law. Next point I'd like to raise. The police make a promise, which is to protect life and property and to uphold the law. The most serious threat to life and property commonly agreed on the planet is environmental damage. Now, the police agree about this as well. I've spoken to many, many police officers over the last 30 years and they all agree with me. It is the most serious threat to life and property. And in terms of aggravated criminal damage, it follows it is the most serious breach of the law as well. This means that, professionally speaking, every police officer should be a committed environmental campaigner. And as I say, I've spoken to enough of them to know that they would if they could, but they've got to do what they're told, they lose their job, and they're not very happy about it. They are protecting the life and the property of the people that are destroying the planet they live on, and their children live on, and they're upholding laws which allow these buggers to continue doing so. I'm an environmental campaigner. As such, I am protecting life and property from the most serious threat to life and property on this planet, and I'm upholding the law from the most serious breach of the law. If I'm to be arrested as an eco-activist by the police and taken to court, they'll have to arrest me and take me to court for upholding the police oath. It's the same for anyone who's an activist for the environment. If you're arrested as an environmental campaigner, you are being arrested and taken to court for upholding the police oath. It's actually a very good defence. I've never been taken to court as an eco-activist.